Hello everybody, this is Ultimate Life Form RB, and welcome to a new recording of Let's Play Metroid Prime for the Nintendo Gamecube. In our last recording, we collected two upgrades for our arm cannon, the Wave Buster and the Ice Beam, and we also collected a new suit upgrade, the Gravity Suit, and we also were able to collect some missile expansion, energy tanks, and a couple Chozo artifacts. And we are currently at 50% completion through the game so far, and now we are going to continue our journey by, in this recording, we are going to enter a new area of the game, and it will actually be the final normal area of the game. So, we're going to start off by going this way. And we're actually going to go to the frigate crash site, which we very briefly visited in the last recording. And we're actually going to be able to do something there. And what we're going to do actually requires the gravity suit. Although it's possible to go through this next area without the gravity suit, it's recommended that you have the gravity suit in order to go through it. If that makes any sense. And right now we're being attacked by flying pirates. A little super missile will take care of things. And actually got a double kill. Very nicely done, Samus. Alright. Now what we need to do is we need to get across this lake, which won't be much of a problem now that we have the gravity suit. Come on, open your mouth. Open your mouth, I say. Good boy. Take care of these annoying gel zaps, and let's grab another missile expansion. I missed it. I jumped over it, I think. I was above it somehow. But anyway, there's our first collectible of the recording. A missile expansion. We now have a maximum of 135 missiles. Just need to collect about 115 more, and we will have the maximum amount of missiles that we can have in the game, which is 250. Alright, now that we're back on dry land, which isn't going to last very long, it is now time for us to enter the downed space frigate. This is the first time we've been to this area since the beginning of the game, but it has changed a lot since that time. Alright, let's drop down this ventilation shaft. It's funny, we were trying to escape the space frigate at the beginning of the game by going through the ventilation shafts. But now we are using these shafts to enter the frigate. Open this big door. And, first of all, boom, and boom. Take out these turrets, which are still functioning somehow, and check out this door. You'll see that it has no power. Here's what we gotta do. We gotta switch to the wave beam, and then we gotta switch to the thermal visor and shoot this target. And that should allow us to go through the door. We're gonna be doing that a lot in this part of the game. We're gonna be using the wave beam to activate power conduits. And we have a new enemy here called the Talon Crab. These guys are like the parasites and whatnot. They travel in swarms, and They will try to, well, swarm Samus. Although, these guys are far more numerous than any of the parasite-type enemies. Usually your best bet is to just ignore them and just keep walking. You know, just don't try to fight them, because there may be too many for you to overcome. And now we enter the main part of the... Now we begin the main portion of this frigate, and we are in the reactor core. Now, those of you that have watched this project since the beginning, you may remember that when we first went through here, the reactor core is where we actually battled the Parasite Queen. Obviously, this part of the level has changed immensely. And I must say that the music that is playing right now is one of my favorite music tracks in the entire game. It's a very calming and soothing piece of music. Then again, this game series, the Metroid Prime Trilogy, has some excellent music, if I say so myself. Unfortunately, we're not alone down here. We have to deal with Aqua Pirates, which are basically flying pirates, except they're, well, they fight underwater. Although the only things that these guys can do is they can launch missile attacks, and that's it. They don't really have any things like... Okay, I'm wrong. They do have blasters on their arms, but mostly they'll just use missile attacks. But it's nothing that a little super missile can't fix. Now, to get out of this room, we have to activate a door that's over there. Unfortunately, there's no power to that door, so much like we did earlier, we have to shoot these power conduits with the wave beam to activate the door. There are four of these panels that we have to shoot in order to progress. So there's two right there. See, go up this way. If I'm right, the last one should be right by the door. Go up to here. Up here. And... bada bing, bada boom. Now open the door. We shall progress. And here's a save station. Might as well do it. I don't want this game freezing on me like it did in the last recording, and then I have to redo everything. That was embarrassing. Don't tell me. I have to shoot something else. Yep, I knew it. That's the thing about Metroid games in general. When you collect an upgrade of any kind, the game will make sure that you put them to use, because there will be puzzles and a lot of other things that will require you to use whatever upgrades you have. Whether it's the spider ball, or the morph ball, or a certain type of beam weapon. They'll make sure you use your upgrades. Now here, if we blow open this door, we can get a new energy tank. So we'll grab that, and continue on our way. Now, originally we could have just taken this elevator to go up this shaft. We don't have that option now. We gotta do this the hard way. And we also have the Aqua Reaper tentacles that are going to cause us problems. And of course, I'm sure you're noticing a general theme here, we have to use the wave beam again. If I'm correct, yes, there's one down here at the bottom of the shaft. Sometimes I try to rush through here, this room, and I forget about the power conduit at the bottom of the shaft. So I have to go all the way back to the ground, back to ground level, and shoot the target, and then I have to go all the way back up. So let's just save time and try to hit that target right now, so I don't have to worry about it later. Let's see. I think the last one's at the top of the room. Let's see. Where do I go from here? That platform looked like it was out of reach for... Holy crap! Whoa, buddy, you don't look so good. I guess he couldn't escape the frigate before it crashed. Get up there. Okay, the last panel should be here. Alright. Onwards. Ah, turrets. Oh, wow, I missed it. I like how it wasn't even attempting to shoot me at first. What is that all about? Now, let's see. Nothing up here. One of these little holding tanks holds a missile expansion, but I don't know which one. Oh boy. Aqua drone. Yeah, there are sentry drones above ground and there are aqua droids in the water. Down you go. Okay. Let's see. Aha! This is the door we want to blow open. Simply shoot at it with a super missile. And another missile expansion belongs to us. So yeah, there's no true upgrade in this area. It's just two missile expansions and two energy tanks. And I'm sure you know the theme here. Gotta shoot some more power conduits so we can open the door. I think this is the next to last room where we have to do this. There's like one more room where we have to do this, and then that's it. Just gotta find the target. Aha. Right. There. Let's say hello. I'm shooting at it. Yeah, the way the wave beam shoots out, it, you know, it does like a triple laser. And the way it goes through the air sometimes, you'll think you've hit your target, but it won't register the hit or something like that. It's weird. It's weird the way the wave beam works. But nonetheless, the door is activated and we can go on. Just gonna roll through all those tentacles. I am not gonna deal with them. What do we got in here? Aqua pirates! You die! You die! What an idiot. He's bumping up against the glass. You die! Okay. Wave beam time, but I think this is the last time. Okay, now just gotta get to the other side. And we'll be done with this area. Like I said, there's no real upgrades or anything. This level, this serves, I guess, as more of a connector Between the Talon Overworld and the level that we're actually about to enter once we get through here. Ow, ow. Ow, that hurts. No, I don't want to be whipped. Random explosion. Random dead body. Ooh, what's that? Aqua Sack. The Aqua Sack enemies, they're very similar to the Sap Sack enemies that you see in the Talon Overworld above ground. But unlike the Sap Sacks, when you shoot the Aqua Sack, they don't blow up. They just dissolve. But they're nothing to worry about. Okay, we're in the last part of the frigate, and it's actually in here where we can get another item, but we have to do the bomb jump. So, first of all... Ah, I timed it wrong. Timed it wrong again. I'm never gonna get that right. Okay, I got it this time. No, I don't. Oh, come on, man! It blows up just a second too late. Wow, are you really kidding me here? Okay. Come on, I nailed this when I was practicing. Why can't I do it now? This bomb jump's a little harder to do because of the underwater physics. I think that's the problem. Yes! Another energy tank. I'll tell you, we're gonna need all the energy and health that we can get, because the next area we're going to is filled with some pretty nasty enemies. And we're out! Just gotta go through this door. And we are back in the, well, technically, we're still in the Talon Overworld. We're just, you know, we're just about to the point where we're going to be getting out of the water, basically. Let's put it that way. Alright, so we're back on dry land. Does anyone have a towel? Guess not. Alright, let's go through the ice beam door and intense radiation detected. What is that stuff? Looks nice and shiny, but I don't think I want to touch it. The music's changed too. Obviously, that is something nasty. Access to Phazon Mines East granted. That's right. Time for a new area. Going down. All right. Let's go. There's that radiation again. Phazon Mines. This is the final normal area of the game. This is where we will find, the last batch of upgrades for us to collect. And this is going to be our toughest area yet. There are a lot of hostile enemies here because this is where this is basically where the space pirates have set up shop for the most part on Talon 4. So we're actually getting really, really close to the end of the game. A lot closer than it looks. I mean, I know I said at the start of the recording that we were only about 50% of the way through the game. The next 50% is going to be coming very, very quickly. Wow! These aren't your normal turrets. These are mega turrets. These turrets are a lot stronger, and they're more heavily armored. Hit them with 3 missiles or a super missile, and you'll get rid of them. Now, we can't go inside the mines themselves because we have a force field that we have to bring down. So let's get to work on doing that. Get out the wave beam. Oh boy, here they come. The rats are gathering. Oh man, I didn't mean to do that. I backed up and I went right. What? Oh, whoa, 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 whoa. Back off, buddy. Who wants some, huh? Who wants some? I'll take you. I'll take you on. Didn't I shoot you already? I guess I didn't kill him. Alright, let's have some fun with the ice beam. You'll drop down, and you will die. Wow, I didn't even freeze him. I just straight up blew him to pieces. Yeah, you gotta watch out for that one space pirate who drops down. That used to catch me by surprise, but I've been through this level so many times and whatnot that it doesn't really shock me anymore. Okay, so we're gonna be using this large crane here in the main quarry of the Phazon Mines to do something. First of all, I need to find the power conduit and shoot it. Now we can have some fun. That ought to wake him up. So there's a missile expansion, and wouldn't you know it, how convenient, this crane has a spider ball track attached to it. Just go along the length of the crane, drop off, and missile expansion once again, and now we're going to reset the crane. And then we're going to have to figure out what we're going to do about that force field that is blocking our way. Okay. Now I just gotta drop down. Secondary force field disabled. And primary force field control disabled. That's our ticket in. But before we go any further, go up here real quick, and we're gonna save. Huh, you think a little gate's gonna stop me? They tried to be tricky, but it didn't quite work.